What's good? This is Marcus DeFingas Manderson back at it again with another video. In this video, I'm going to show you all my new home studio setup. Just got sort of situated a little bit this past weekend. Had a lot of family come over on their wedding anniversary, helping put this thing together. On the holiday weekend, helping put this thing together to help me get a creative space that I can continue to work out of, both for work and do music out of. So we're gonna get right into it. Here we go. So here we go. We gonna go right into this room right here. Got the lock on there. And I'm gonna go over everything you see in here, but basically this desk took us 5 hours to find this desk this past weekend. We went everywhere, furniture stores, mom and pop like thrift stores, found this. It happened to be, we even went to Walmart, Target. We were out there for 5 hours. It was pouring down rain at some point throughout the day, and we actually found this L-shaped Gillespie desk at Staples. It was the last one they had in stock, and then got it home that night, and I sort of put it together in here, and then family came over to help get this room together. But the desk is where everything is housed on. I will get to what's on the desk in a minute, but first we'll go over the wall space. So let me close the door here. We're gonna start right with on the left here. So I had won three of these signs in a contest years ago. I believe it was either production contest or fill out a form contest, and I always had these, and these actually have been in this room before in the previous setup. I remember years ago when we first moved into this house, I came home one day and my wife and her mom had these pictures all up on the wall, and I felt official then. Now I really feel official now with this setup. One says Got Beats, the other one, the red one, NPC user, the yellow one, Caution Producer at Work. Got a music clock up there, another gift from my wife years ago, where the times are actually music keys, circle of fifths, for those that want that tier. Below that we have a TV, you know, Apple TV, you know, can put the game on, working on music, producing, doing whatever, or watching, you know, whatever I want to watch. We got a little sort of couch here, some pillows. It's a futon, so it folds down into a bed. And then on the back side of the desk, we have a little refrigerator there. Got my ring lights for when I'm doing videos in the room. And then on the windowsill, so this curtain actually was running all the way down to the floor there. My mom, my wife's mom, came in, took these curtains, cut them up, did her seamstress thing, cut them to the exact length, folded them up, put some tape on. I mean, she did the thing. Like, y'all can see, like, this was all the way down to the ground, and she like did the sewing thing and got that together. These music notes, this is actually gift. This one is a gift from my wife's mom and her husband, as a gift from them for, I believe it was Father's Day. And then this is a gift from my wife. I believe it was also Father's Day. So I have them in the windowsill. Got to put some more stuff up here. Some little, plaques and things. This is from an event I used to play for annually, years ago. This is from 2008, but I played there for about 10 or 15 years. And then this is a music, staff notebook that I can put in sheet music that my wife gave me. And then here is the official desk. Above that we have JMU plaque, Bachelor of Music from JMU. And then I have a Pro Tools certification right there. Then above that, Omega Studio Certificate of Audio Productions from the Omega Studios Applied Recording Arts and Sciences. I do have a master's from Full Sail I got to put somewhere in this room, on a wall. I believe that'll be coming shortly. And then to the gear itself, a lot of Yamaha gear. We'll start with the Yamaha gear. Yamaha keyboard. This is a Yamaha Motif 7. I've had this since 2001. Still works great. Has some incredible sounds in there. This is the OG Motif. And then I also use it as a MIDI controller, using a Yamaha BT. You see these... this Bluetooth wireless BT MD-01, I believe, controller to control like Logic Pro or to control the iPad, which we'll get to shortly. But Yamaha Motif keyboard, another OG Yamaha product, Yamaha AW16G, is a mixer that I got while in college. This is where I recorded all my songs on. It actually burns to a CD, and you can bounce it out. But now with MIDI, you can still connect everything through MIDI and have the faders control software and things like that. I have two Yamaha HS 50Ms, I believe, monitors here. Something happened, you know, where they got indented on the inside, but the sound still sounds incredible. And then I have
a Mac Mini, a Mac Cinema display here that ties to a Mac Pro laptop. And then below that is a master voice channel by Aphex. It's basically a channel strip where you can plug a microphone into and get some, dial in your voice settings, settings for voice. And then all the gear is going into this 402 VLZ3 mixer, which then goes into a headphone distribution, and then out of the distribution, the Presonus HP4 out of here into the speakers, and then if we have headphones, I'll plug the headphones up here, and then I have a microphone. My wife bought me this microphone several years ago. This is about a $500 microphone, a Groove Tubes GT57. It's actually inside of this ball here, the GT57 microphone. And then this Chaotica eyeball, I actually won in another contest sponsored by Tracklib, and the prize was a Chaotica eyeball. So I'm using that here in the setup here. So that's the quick overview. A lot of music being made, of course. I'm still using the iPad to make music on BeatMaker 3. If I'm using the laptop, I'm mainly using Logic Pro X 10.5, the latest version of Logic Pro. Yeah, that's the setup, man. So I always was spending time in here, so I'm gonna be spending even more time in here, making music, making stuff that hopefully the world will be hearing shortly. Hold on, I gotta get to the picture. This is a prom picture, 2002. Me and my girlfriend at the time, she's my wife now. This is a prom picture from 2002, and then behind that is a lava lamp from Phil, who passed away several years ago. He loved lava lamps, always turned that on every morning, we got that from him. So of course, you know, what studio space isn't complete without a lava lamp? So got that in there.
Yeah, so that's the quick overview of the new sort of production setup, studio setup I have here. Again, more music gonna be made, more videos, if not more, at least the same amount that I've been making in the past that you've been seeing. But more ideas on the way, more videos on the way. Stay safe and be well, everyone. All right, peace.